Gamers of Reddit, what are some good quotes from video games? No tricks. This potato only generates 1.1 volts of electricity. I literally do not have the energy to lie to you. Edit. Game is Portal 2. Did you ever try to put a broken piece of glass back together? Even if the pieces fit, you can't make it whole again the way it was. But if you're clever, you can still use the pieces to make other useful things. Maybe even something wonderful, like a mosaic. Well, the world broke just like glass, and everyone's trying to put it back together like it was. But it'll never come together in the same way. Moira Brown. Fallout 3. Somehow, I don't remember this. It's beautiful, for how horribly annoying Moira was and the stupid, dangerous things she asked you to do. I did always feel like she was one of the few people left in the world whose heart was really in the right place. I'd get tempted to take a shortcut like lying to her about the task she'd given me. But if she was trying to make the world a better place, wouldn't tricking her make it worse? It literally does for some of the choices. The survival guide is worse and is reflected in the stats boost you get from the perk and unique dialogue from a random encounter with a wastelander who has the book. I always liked that canonically it was confirmed in New Vegas that the Lone Wanderer helped Moira with every task honestly and even completed the bonus optional objectives. Namely because when you find a wasteland survival guide in FNV it gives you a massive boost to your survival skill. If I'm wearing a bikini, where do I put my Pokeballs? Teehee, woman's secret. Thanks Pokemon. This one is especially concerning when you remember that the in-game character that she's addressing is a 10-year-old child. The right man in the wrong place can make all the difference in the world. So, wake up Dr. Freeman, wake up and smell the ashes. If you find yourself in a hole, the first thing to do is stop digging. John Marston. I was always partial to the late-game RDR quote. We can't always change, but we have to try. Even if it means starting over 1,000 times. It's better than going back to the way things were. Well done. Here are the test results. You are a horrible person. I'm serious. That's what it says. A horrible person. We weren't even testing for that. Don't let that horrible person thing discourage you. It's just a data point. If it makes you feel any better, science has now validated your birth mother's decision to abandon you on a doorstep. GLaDOS. Portal 2. GLaDOS. This statement is asterisk asterisk false asterisk asterisk. Don't think about it, don't think about it, don't think about it. Wheatley. True. I'm gonna go with true. Overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. Darkest Dungeon has way too many memorable quotes, but this one is my favorite. Asterisk many fall in the face of chaos, asterisk, asterisk but not this one, asterisk, 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 not today, asterisk, asterisk. Trevor. Well hello there beautiful. Here go buy yourself something nice. Girl. Is this $7? Quote. Trevor. I said something nice, not something expensive. Quote. No thanks, I don't do weed. It interferes with the speed. Also Trevor. Unfortunately, killing is one of those things that gets easier the more you do it. Solid Snake. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA. I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you. Fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts. Portal 2. Portal 2 has the best video game quotes by far. I've never laughed so hard from any other game. Everyone thinks they're the hero of their own story. Handsome Jack from the Borderlands games. I'm so glad to see Jack here. My favorite quote is the paragraph about New Haven. See, this is what I don't get about you bad guys. You know the hero's gonna win, but you never just die quickly. man, this one guy in New Haven. Right, city's burning, people dying, blah blah blah. This guy rushes me with a spoon. A freaking spoon. And I'm just dying laughing. So I scoop out his eyeballs with it. And his kids are all, wah, single quote. And, aw, you had to be there. Anyway, the moral is, you're a total bitch. Greater than I'm racking my brain trying to think of a name for that diamond pony I bought. I was gonna call it Piss for Brains in honor of you. But that just feels immature. Maybe Butt Stallion? Nah, that's even worse. I'll give it some more thought. Greater than I should probably clarify the diamond horse I've been telling you about. It's not a sculpture or anything. It's a living horse that actually happens to be made of actually. I'll just go get her. Butt Stallion. Say hello. Horse whinnies. Greater than Butt Stallion says hello. God, these prestals suck. You exist because we allow it, and you will end because we demand it. Ah yes, reapers. We have dismissed that climacure. Had to be me. Someone else might have gotten it wrong. Morton Solus. I consider this one of the best final lines of any character in fiction. It's true to character. Poignant. Witty. Bittersweet. And badass all at once. In the game Bastion, during the tutorial phase you learn that a large part of your environment is destructible with your hammer. If you smash a bunch of things for a while, the narrator comes in and says the kid just rages for a while. I thought it was clever that they anticipated people to just destroy the environment when they learn they can. Falls off the edge greater than the kid fell to his death. Respawns greater than I'm just fooling. Just like the simulations. Unknown 501st clone trooper. When the 501st was finally rotated out of Felucia, Ayla Secura made a point of seeing us off personally, calling us the bravest soldiers she had ever seen. It's a good thing we were wearing helmets, because none of us could bear to look her in the eye. Same clone trooper, more emotional quote. Where the men cried. What I remember most about the fall of the Republic was how quiet it was. In the closing days of the Clone War, the 501st was discreetly transferred back to Coruscant. We all knew what was about to happen. What we were about to do. Were there any doubts? Any private, traitorous thoughts? Maybe. But no one said a word. Not on the whole trip. Not when Order 66 came down. And not when we marched on the Jedi Temple. Not a word. And you'll get plenty of chances to hear this chilling speech as you rush to save the goddamned library archives on the 100th attempt. War is when the young and stupid are tricked by the old and bitter into killing each other. Nico. From GTA 4. I survived because the fire inside burned brighter than the fire around me. Joshua Graham. Nobody's dick's that long. Not even Long Dick Johnson. And he had a fucking long dick. Thus the name. I fucking love New Vegas, man. Their rage. Brutal. Without mercy. But you will be worse. Rip and tear. Until it is done. Edit. Thanks for the gold. Kind stranger. Heavy metal intensifies. I do believe I'm on fire TF2 spy while burning alive. Greater than your white flag does not stop American bullets. Quote. If God wanted you to live, he wouldn't have created me. Asterisk asterisk protocol 3. Protect a pilot asterisk asterisk. Titanfall 2, perhaps the biggest gaming surprise of this decade. The first game was pretty good, but entirely multiplayer. Then along comes Titanfall 2. It improves on literally every aspect of the first game, while also introducing the best FPS storyline I've played since the Halo series. The movement is addicting. The gunplay is accurate and satisfying. You get giant mechs. And I still get emotional when I think about my giant Titan BFF handing me a god-tier gun in the last act of the single player and says, survive. You bet I did, BT. They never knew what hit you, monsieur. Damn, we need Titanfall 3. Probably my favorite FPS games of all time. Similar, but I prefer the Protocol 3. I will not lose another pilot. Gets me every time. asterisk protocol 1, link to pilot asterisk protocol 2, uphold the mission asterisk protocol 3, protect the pilot asterisk. Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman. Rise and shine. Not that I wish to imply you've been sleeping on the job. No one is more deserving of a rest, and all the effort in the world would have gone to waste until, well, let's just say that your hour has come again. The right man in the wrong place can make all the difference in the world. So, wake up, Mr. Freeman. Wake up and smell the ashes. Uther, I dearly hope that there's a special place in hell waiting for you. Arthas, we may never know. Uther, I intend to live forever. Warcraft 3, Reign of Chaos. You're finally awake, trying to cross the border, eh? Walked right into that Imperial ambush. You have died of dysentery, Oregon Trail. Despite everything, it's still you, not a huge Undertale fan, but that line gets me every time. My favorite deep line from Undertale is from Asriel in the epilogue. Something like, "Be careful, Frisk. There are a lot of flowies out there, and you can't always make things better by taking about them, monsieur. You forget 1,000 things each day. How about you make sure this is one of them, tilde Michael DeSanta? GTA 5, are we rushing in, or are we going sneaky-beaky-like? Very cheeky-breaky. You picked the wrong house, fool. Big smoke. Hashtag ALLWEHADTODOWASFOLLOWTHEDAMNTRAINCJ. Waka waka waka, waka waka, waka waka waka, waka waka. Waka, waka waka, Pac-Man. No, 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 I can't die like this. Not when I'm so close. And not at the hands of a filthy bandit. I could have saved this planet. I could have actually restored order. And I wasn't supposed to die by the hands of a child-killing psychopath. You're a savage. You're a maniac. You are a bandit. And I am the goddamn hero. Quote, you are a horrible person. We weren't even testing for that. Aperture Science, bring your daughter to work day is the perfect time to have her tested. War never changes. War has changed. It's no longer about nations, ideologies, or ethnicity. It's an endless series of proxy battles fought by mercenaries and machines. War, and its consumption of life, has become a well-oiled machine. War has changed. ID-tagged soldiers carry ID-tagged weapons. Use ID-tagged gear. Nanomachines inside their bodies enhance and regulate their abilities. Genetic control. Information control. Emotion control. Battlefield control. Everything is monitored and kept under control. War has changed. The age of deterrence has become the age of control. All in the name of averting catastrophe from weapons of mass destruction. And he who controls the battlefield controls history. War has changed. When the battlefield is under total control, war becomes routine. When the white frost comes, don't eat the yellow snow. Quote, we've stepped into a war with a cabal on Mars. So let's get to taking out their command, one by one. Valus Tark, from what I can gather, he commands the siege dancers from an Imperial land tank. Outside of Rubicon, he's well protected, but with the right team, we can punch through those defenses, take this beast out, and break their grip on Freehold. Serious Destiny answer. Doing the last wish raid with the fail-safe dialogue wish active. Elizabeth Sobeck. It was a children's electronics kit, but I'd hacked the wiring to an auto battery and solar PV. So the grass caught fire. And so did a tall pine that had stood there. I don't know, maybe 100 years. My mother was home, thank God. So she called the fire department and after, she took me out on the lawn and showed me the dead baby birds. Because there were nests in the pine tree. Gaia, query, what did you feel? Sobeck, I'm not sure. I remember yelling that I didn't care. And that's when my mother took my face in her hands and spoke. Gaia, query, what did she say? Sobeck, she said I had to care. she said. Elizabeth, being smart will count for nothing if you don't make the world better. You have to use your smarts to count for something. To serve life, not death. A conversation between an AI and her designer in Horizon Zero Dawn. So many great ones in Horizon Zero Dawn. It had been a while since a game had grabbed me so much. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.